Hey everyone, Drew Hinton here from Aero Safety. In honor of NIOSH's Respiratory Protection Week, we're going to try to bring you tips and tricks this week, every day, to provide a better understanding of what your respirator is, how to use it, and some things that you can take back to your organization or your home. And so for today's lesson, we're going to look at how to select the proper respirator. And so I have with me here is a 3M 6200 model. It's an air purifying respirator. As you can see, the filters and cartridges are not on here. But it's a 3M 6000 series respirator. So this is an air purifying respirator, which means it purifies the air coming in. It does not provide any oxygen. So that tells me I have to have oxygen in the environment. But how do I know if this is going to work? And so in order to know what respirator I need to know two things. And so first off, what chemical am I protecting myself against? Am I protecting myself against carbon monoxide, CO? Am I protecting myself against hydrogen sulfide, H2S? Is it anhydrous ammonia? Is it sulfuric acid? The list goes on and on. So I need to know what chemical it is. So the process is the same as far as what chemical it is, but we need to know what chemical we're protecting ourselves against. And yes, there are certain cartridges out here that will fit these filters that will protect against multiple chemicals. And there are cartridges and filters that will protect against single chemicals or one chemical protection. And so I figure out what chemical I'm going to protect myself against. So we're going to say that we're protecting ourselves against carbon monoxide or CO. It's a common chemical. It's one that most of us are at least familiar with. Maybe we're not exposed to it as much as others, but we're at least familiar with what it is. And so now that I know what chemical I'm protecting myself against, now I need to determine what protection factor is needed. So I need to get a gas meter, portable gas meter, portable air monitor, whatever you want to call it, some way to figure out how much concentration is in the ambient air. And so we're going to say that the ambient air in our environment is 100 parts per million of carbon monoxide, just to make it simple. And so in order to determine the mass that's needed, you need to figure out what's called an assigned protection factor, which an assigned protection factor, an APF, is basically giving you a level of protection that's needed based on the mask that you're using. And so what you do with that is you take your ambient atmospheric concentration. So again, we just said it's 100 parts per million of carbon monoxide, CO, and then you divide that by the occupational exposure limit that you're going off of. Now, OSHA's PEL, the permissible exposure limit, is 50 parts per million. But most of us are more familiar with NIOSH's recommended exposure limit of 35 parts per million. That's what most of your portable gas meters or air monitors are programmed to, is the 35 parts per million threshold. But we're going to make things simple just because OSHA is the legal limit. So we're going to make things simple for you. So what you do is you divide your ambient concentration by the limit that you're wanting to establish, and that will give you your assigned protection factor. So again, we set our occupational exposure limit, ambient concentration was 100 parts per million. And so we're going to divide that by 50. We're going to use OSHA's PEL. We're going to divide that by 50 to keep it simple. So 100 divided by 50 gives me an answer of 2. And so that 2 is now my required assigned protection factor. So I have to have a respirator that provides me at least an APF of 2 or higher. Now, where do I find that information? You can go to OSHA's regulations 1910.134. They have a table in there that breaks down all the types of masks. They'll break it down based on whether it's a quarter style mask, it's a half mask, full face, is it an air purifying respirator, is it an SCBA, self-contained breathing apparatus, whatever type of mask style mask that you want to use, it will tell you the assigned protection factor that that mask will provide. Now, a quarter style air purifying respirator, quarter mask, will provide an APF of 5. And so this half face here that I have will provide an assigned protection factor of 10. So again, we said we needed an APF of at least 2. So for that example, the quarter mask or the quarter style mask, air purifying respirator, that'll suffice because I need 2, it's going to give me 5. So anything above a quarter mask, so this half mask will work, a full face mask will work. Anything above that quarter style mask, above a 2, will provide adequate protection. Now let's say for a hypothetical situation, we're not going to discuss why the CO is this high, let's say that we have an ambient air concentration of 1,500 parts per million of CO. And so what we're going to do now is we're going to take a concentration of 1,500 parts per million, divide that by our OSHA PEL 50. So 1,500 divided by 50 gives me a 30. So I need an APF of at least 30. So again, we talked about our quarter style mask provides an APF of 5. So that one's out of the question. This half face respirator, air purifying respirator, will provide me an APF of 10. So if I need 30, this is not going to cut it either. So the next step up, if I'm wanting to use air purifying respirators, the next step up will be a full face air purifying respirator. And that will provide me an assigned protection factor of 50. So we're needing 30. The first two, the quarter style, the half mask, those won't work because it's 5 and 10 respectively. So I need to bump it up to the next one, which is a full face APR, which provides me an APF of 50. And so now that I figure that out, I know that I need a full face APR. Now I need to figure out what type of cartridge is needed. So am I dealing with chlorine? Am I dealing with carbon monoxide? Am I working in a paint booth? I need to know what classification it is, because depending on what classification it is, it's going to determine what type of cartridge or filter I'm going to need. Again, there are some out there that are what they call multi-chemical or multi-vapor P100 cartridges or filters, and they will provide protection against a lot of chemicals, but they will not provide protection against every chemical. And so you need to figure out what it is, and then you'll also look at the manufacturer. So if it's 3M, when I break into the bag of this 3M respirator, it will have a chart that shows me what's compatible with this mask, which filter is compatible, and it will tell me a part number for that. And so understanding what type of respirator you will need is based on what chemical you're protecting yourself against, and then also how much chemical am I protecting myself against? How much protection do I need? And so once you understand those two things, then you can make an accurate decision on what type of respirator is needed. And then up to, after that, it's really up to the organization on whether you want to use a 3M, do you want to use an MSA, do you want to use a Miller, what type of mask manufacturer you use, that's completely up to you. Now, we'll get into in another video, we'll get into the OSHA requirements as far as making fit testing. And one of those fit test options and requirements is making sure there's different types of masks and different styles available for the respirator user to choose from. And so we'll get into that on the next video, but I just want to provide a brief tutorial on how to select the proper respirator, some of the assigned protection factors and the fit factors, and we'll talk again a little bit more on the next videos. So again, appreciate your all's time. If you have more questions, feel free to reach out to us at www.aerosafetyus.com. Again, thanks and have a great week.